you know, you're showing me this team, and this is a wonderful story.
Yeah.
Because an old colleague of mine runs this team. He's a Kashmiri Muslim, and his partner is a Kashmiri Pandit. So if you ever want to know what is possible in India, just look at Real Kashmir. It's a football team that has just defeated the likes of the mighty Mohun Bagan and East Bengal. So why can't we have more Real Kashmirs? That's the question I want to ask you. It is my friend who's a journalist who's made this team, not the politicians, not your mother, not Omar Abdullah, not Farooq Abdullah. The people of Kashmir made Real Kashmir. Government is saying, we are going to create 1,000 Real Kashmirs. We are going to make Kashmir bloom again. Now that Article 3...
Wait, can I interject?
Yes.
Kashmiris have been caged for the past 2 months. You keep talking about the future. Can we talk about now, Rajdeep? Can we talk about the humanitarian crisis? Can we talk about the economic crisis? Can we talk about the psychological crisis? Can we talk about the trauma that you're subjecting people to? Can we talk about the constitutional harakiri that BJP has done? Can we talk about the constitutional desecration that they've done, the illegal, undemocratic manner in which this entire dubious process was carried out? I mean, I'm only hearing about this is for the benefit of Kashmiris. If I'm doing something for your benefit, do you not have that right? Are you not entitled to that right? Where in a civil society where you have a debate, where you talk about if it's good for you, if it's acceptable to you. I mean, if this decision was, Kashmiris are part of this process, right? You didn't even consult them. So how can you justify it by selling them dreams of the future?
You say there is a health economic crisis at the moment. Are you telling me that Kashmiris are, in a sense, angry today because of what's happened? Are you telling me that they are not willing to give the government of India a chance to perhaps try and break the status quo that's existed over the last couple of decades? Try something new.
Try something new that starts with betrayal of their trust. Do you know the manner in which this was done? People were told that, you know, we're expecting an attack from Pakistan, and that's why the yatris were driven out. We had such an amazing tourist season happening. According to the government's own admission, I have to say terrorism happens according to their convenience. So last year, after governor's rule was imposed for a year, they said, oh, everything is fine in the valley. There's no stone pelting. There's no terrorism. There's no infiltration. Now, all of a sudden, there's terrorism. There's infiltration. There's stone pelting. I mean, you guys paint Kashmiris as devils, you know, you paint them as subhuman people. All they want to do is come out and pelt stones. All of a sudden, in the past month and a half, Kashmiris are suddenly peace-loving. So you people also are responsible. The media is responsible. Look at the way you distort the ground reality, Rajdeep. Is it fair to Kashmiris?
You know, you're going on saying you people.
I hold the media responsible as well.
You hold the media responsible?
Yes.
For all that's gone wrong in Kashmir
over the last
few decades?
Not for all that's gone wrong, but I say the coverage, I mean, it's shameful. Look at a BBC, look at Al Jazeera. I met my mother, I met lots of people in Kashmir, and they all said that, oh, you know what? I'm sorry, but India Today, Republic, they're all being slotted in the same category, and they're so angry that you're not even projecting the ground realities, Rajdeep.